with your purple label. Shout out to Houston.
It's going down in H.
Somebody
had a screw up for you.
Hold on, baby.
Y'all never heard Joe a screw, huh? So I was talking to Kayla Styles, and she was like, "You going to the station, right?" I said, "Yeah." She's like, "Why don't you go sit in the chair?" Translation, boy, you looking rough. So I said, "I don't have that much time." She said, "How much time do you have?" Now I'm gonna show you how good a stylist this person is. 25 minutes. I got all that. 25 minutes. Done. SBK, Styles by Kayla. I'm telling y'all right now, if you want a good hairstylist, a certified master hairstylist, I'm telling you, you want to go to that experience. When I call it an experience, it's so because she not only does hair, it's a whole spa. When black people keep talking about, we have nothing for us. We have nothing for us. We have to go to Wing Wing. No, you don't. No, you don't. You got to go off of 249. And there's an all-black salon ran by a sister who does very good work. Now, I'm excited. I'm going to tell y'all why I'm excited. My tribal brothers, for those who know, I am part of a tribe.
Hey.
Ancestors in training. My brothers, whom I love dearly.
SOS.
Chakra Phantom in the building. Hey. Bam! Look at him.
Hey.
Smash on sight. And chew your food. See, y'all don't know those are inside jokes.
Right.
They remember me as a person saying, "Turn it off, turn it off, turn it off." And we was doing a literal retreat, a spiritual retreat.
Yes, sir.
And I was new to the walk, and I was trying to figure out, you know, you go through your processes of trying to find out who you are. Sure. These brothers, right here, see them? Minus one. Two.
Quite a few, but they're here.
These brothers are actually responsible for me actually getting closer and more in tune with the other me and who I am, and had me tap into myself 10 times over. And I'm grateful. I literally owe these brothers my life, because they've changed my life, and I greatly appreciate it. But today, y'all know how I do it. It's not going to be about me. It's going to be about them. It's going to be a good vibration station vibe. They're here to raise the vibration. Now, y'all know how I do it. I'm going to flip it on to them, but I'm going to be asking questions.
Ratchet.
But that's how we're going to do it. So, brothers, please introduce yourselves. Who want to go first?
I'm Ra. Ra Kepri Patai. Phantom of the Chakras. Coach E. Coach Edward. Big Splash Swim School. Hey, man, we here to rock out. Help raise your vibrations. Gonna help y'all learn how to hold your vibration after this moment.
Okay. Next.
I got you. Peace, love, and blessings, fam. Coach Sobek Elegua El Demare here. Owner of Loyalty Life Legacy, which is 100% veteran-owned life coaching organization focused on universal wellness, health, and motivation through action. I'm just here with my brothers, Chakra Phantoms. I'm one of the new inductees, and we're all about vibration, raising your vibration, and helping you through this time period of idiocy, which many are waking up to that has been here forever. So,
all right,
let's tap in.
Next up,
Uncle Johnson Nev, Vitality in Life, Life and Vitality. I am Jehudi, my unk, also known as Coach Craigler from Big Splash Swim School. Chakra of the Phantoms, like my brother say, we're here to put you in a higher vibrational state,
right,
so you too can take advantage of the planetary shift.
So you too can raise your vibrations.
But this doesn't matter.
All right, so let's talk about it, y'all. Let's talk about this for a second. All right, I'm gonna come around here with my brothers right quick. Turn it that way. Yeah, let's flip it. Ding ding, being difficult.
Like a girl.
Bam. All right. So, let's talk about it, y'all.
Let's talk about it.
Everything that has been happening, because we said, some people were saying 2021 wouldn't be that bad. Right. It'll be like a, man, we gonna be so glad to be out of 2020. We in 2021 and everything's gonna be all right. And we see kind of, no. It's actually, because I told people, I said, you think 2020 is something. You ain't seen nothing until you see 2021. It's going down.
Yeah.
And January came in and it shows I'm black and lovely. Yeah. Bam! I mean, it didn't wait. It ain't wait. Ain't take no lunch break. It ain't no, I'm going to take a nap. It was like 2021, January 1st. Click, click, Civil War. Let's go. Let's get it.
Yeah.
So it's like, Let's talk about how that affects us, because I keep telling people a lot of this stuff doesn't have anything to do with us as a people, as a collective, but I'm seeing people get affected by it. So let's talk about how that affects vibrations for a second.
First and foremost, we know that the media is put in place to control vibrations. So when you wake up first thing in the morning and you watching all of what they're calling a travesty or the most horrific thing on the planet, that's meant to control your vibration. How it affects us as a culture is we're seeing the changing of the guards. The last is now becoming the first again, and they don't like it.
Mm-hmm. Now, when you say the last is becoming the first, elaborate on that.
For those who are deeply steeped in Christianity or Abrahamic faiths, there is discussion of the last being first in many of these scriptures that talks about the sons of Ham being slaves that are now coming back into where we originally were. Their history is not our history. Our history has been hidden from us, because the reality is if we know who we are and we stand up for who we are, then the game is over.
Ashe. Anybody else want to tap in on that?
I'll go in. First off, 2020 has been great. I wouldn't call it a bad year at all.
Yes.
My brothers and I have been transforming. Some of the things that we were thinking about leaving were actually ripped away by the universe.
One second. Don't worry about that right there. So, this is our metaphysical devil trying to mess with us. We will take care of that.
That's it right there.
We will take care of that.
That is it right there.
We hope, hold on. We hope all of your chakras are disrupted when we hit our soundboard. Alright, got dog. That's when we started. It sounded like somebody doing a dog online dance next door.
It's alright. So like Big Brother Moon was saying, like 2020 is like ground zero. It's gonna get worse before it gets better. And hopefully you guys have been doing the work.
What now? What work is that?
Work is work for me. I can't speak for everybody. But work for me has been shadow work and fighting the lower self.
Okay.
Not exactly killing the ego because you are who you are, but raising your vibration so little stuff doesn't hurt you or disrupt you, so you can receive your blessings.
I say.
So man.
Right. Knock it out. Rod finna get with me. This one is deep. All three of these brothers are deep. When I sit around in a cypher with them, sometimes I be sitting like, hey man, look, I lift weights and I know how to shoot. Right. And then sometimes I tap in, but when Rod starts talking, Rod be like, well, you know when you look at a butterfly. Think about all the chemical components.
Oh, man.
The
butterfly. Oh, man. Oh,
so go ahead and talk about it, man.
Man, 2020, man, the mirror, the reflection, you know, really. I can say that a lot of us, we found out that we was white people.
What do you mean by this?
Man, our actions, the way when you, you know what I'm saying? Your skin, you're black. Man, we've been raised in the system the whole way that we even view ourselves and even the way we view our interactions.
Are you speaking of whitewashed?
Whitewashed, brainwashed, you know, and coming to that revelation for myself this past 2020. It was, you know, really everybody's like, all right, now is everybody looking in this same mirror? And a lot of people are getting mad because now they up here in arms at the Capitol because they done seen themselves.
Okay.
Speak on it.
Okay.
Nice.
Okay. Now, Sister Denise, bam! So, talk about it. What do you get out of this?
Well, so I didn't really watch, like, certain stuff will disturb you, and we know it's meant to disturb you, so I didn't watch. But I did hear little, you know, here's and there's. I saw a little clip, social media, they catch you up on a lot of stuff. People climbing, breaching, and all this other stuff. Like, real life war, real life civil war happening. And it's just one of those situations where we have to, like, it ain't our fight. We got to step out of it, mind our own business. And get it together.
Okay.
Mind
okay.
Spiritual.
Now, if y'all don't mind,
say it again.
Let me tap in.
I gotta jump in. Get a double dash. All right. So, to me, from your ego perspective, if we want to look at something built, y'all know who I pray to, and you know what we always say, what I always say to my soldiers in Anubis. Shout out to my troops in Anubis. Sometimes to build something, you got to tear everything down.
Sure.
So I call this the reestablishment of Olokun. The foundation, right? We have to put African roots on it, though, because a lot of us, like Ross said, has been whitewashed. We mayonnaise, man.
Hey.
We like spicy mayonnaise. You know what I'm saying? So with that being said, we gotta figure out. It's the sport. Well, a lot of us are going to have to figure ourselves out. Stop following trends. Stop doing what they doing. Like, I had a lot of people mad because they're like, why? I don't see nothing to do. Black militias out there fighting. Hey, man, just because they doing it don't mean I got to do it. That ain't our fight.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? I'm not walking into the Capitol building. You know what's in there? A whole bunch of laws that is designed against our people. Unless they're going to have a big symposium about how to get rid of these video, to get rid of the 13th, 14th, and 15th Amendments so we can no longer be three-fifths human.
I see.
Now, if we're talking about reparations, slide me on in, play them in there. But if we're talking about Trump or Biden, I'm going to go take a nap or maybe eat some popcorn after I work out, drink some orange juice, watch a show, chill with the phantoms, and raise my vibrations. Now, how I think this conversation is important, family, because at the end of the day, you're going to see a lot of emotions this year, predominantly depression, especially amongst our people, because there are those of us who think that what applies to them makes us happy. The country's safe. Get pulled over. Do you feel safe when you're pulled over? I definitely don't feel safe when I'm pulled over. I'm like, should I have my pistol on my head? Just in case. You know, is my body on me in the backseat? I don't know.
You know, that's designed the same way, too. Because what two colors you see when the police pull you over?
Yeah, blue and red, crimson bloods.
No, not only that. What chakras is that? Your root chakra and your throat chakra.
Okay.
So
okay.
Automatically, your sense of security is gone.
Yeah.
So I feel like.
Yeah, like you can't talk. Knowledge.
Yeah, that's yeah. your power.
You out of there.
Mm-hmm.
Red and blue chakra, and the people that designed this game, they know this.
They know about it. They know about this.
See, this is why I love these people.
I like
right
when you say that.
This is why I love these folks right here. Chakra, this is why I love these brothers right here. I wish Afara was here too, because Afara would throw it in there. Karamoka was here, right. Julian, they throw it off in there. My eye might come out of somewhere speaking Spanish. But, but at the end of it, shout out to the tribe, man. I love y'all. But we're going to get into some good music right quick. We're going to keep on vibing out. And when these brothers are ready to get into it, they're going to get into it. But in the meantime, in between time, all we're going to do is vibe out. We're going to continue to build. But I tell y'all what, we will not let this night end without this beautiful thing called a sound bath. Because everybody listening tonight is about to get a very big blessing. If you're dealing with some stuff inside of you, this is the time where you close your eyes, meditate, and deal with it face to face. All right, so we will have a meditation session towards the end. But right now, I'm only finna get up in here and I'm sorry, I gotta get my chill voice because this is not a rap day. This is a chill music. Right now, we're getting ready to play the sound.
Thank you. ceremony that's going on. They got me playing drums over there and stuff.
Get in there!
Vibrations Station Radio. Chaka Phantoms is in the building. We are building on Vibrations right now. And like I tell folks, man, we mean what we say. We say what we mean. Oh, now we got to talk about... Now, you know who has action figures. Well, the beautiful thing about our walk is we do too, but they actually do stuff. So, Chaka Phantoms, please introduce us to our friends on the table. See, y'all don't know, this is creativity right here. You see that? That is true creativity right there. So, let's go to the person that made it, and the names, and what he does. See, this is my big homie right here, Nomo. Shout out to Nomo. Me and Nomo go back. Me and Nomo go back to a day we had to break out some tables. That's one of my tag team partners right there. There's Nomo. Now, who is this one?
This is Free.
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 See, Free look like, is that, Free like, he about that action.
Free is about that action. Free has everything that you need to get free.
Free has everything you need to be free. So what about this one?
This is Flu.
Flu?
Flu. Because I flew here.
Okay.
Transcending through dimensions.
Hey, now, I ain't trying to sound like a hater, but I don't bend copper. I do metal. I work on cars. These people been in copper making whole action figures. G.I. Joe ain't got nothing on this. Nothing on this. He got the Kung Fu look. Look at Nomo. This is my guy right here. I'm not going to touch him. That's how much I love him. He got the doggone. He got the mace in his hand, the bush upside the head, just in case your chakras ain't aligned. Then on top of that, he got a little crystal dagger in case he got to cut somebody. Then he got a sword on the side because he really ain't got no time to be playing with you. Then he got a backpack with some extra stuff. I don't even know what's in the backpack. It's a stone, obviously, but he probably got something else because that's Nomo. That is the number one of three cosmic warriors of... Yeah, anyway. Yeah, so let's keep talking about vibrations and everything. And because I always tell people, when you deal with radio waves and stuff like that, you deal with yourself as a conductor. Yes. So think of us like wire. You know what I mean? So we got to think of us like wire. Like, that's why we wear copper. Mm-hmm. That's why we wear certain things. Like, they look at our jewels. Like, they have beautiful jewelry on, which they make. You know, y'all want to show it off, feel free. Yeah. But they make this jewelry, and they are black business owners, so you already know what time it is. If you would like some, you need to talk to Chaka Phantom and get your gift. So, but I would say the protection is necessary thing for stainless steel to copper because of energy conductivity.
Yes, sir.
All right, because it prevents cross-transmittal confusion. And people say, what's cross-transmittal confusion? It's basically where your mind's going this way, and you can have a psychic vampire come up and they say, you know, you over here. You mad for no reason. You don't even know why. You distressed. You sad for no reason. You don't even know why. You worried about everything that don't even apply to you because you're confused.
Yes, sir.
When you woke up, great. You rose great. You rose up in a great mood. Everything was lovely, happy, feeling life, you know what I mean? And all of a sudden, man, I got all these bills. That's why I tend to, when people tell me problems, I tend to go, all right, okay. Because one thing I've learned since being in this walk is be very cautious of your energy. Sure. I'm talking about even loved ones. Yeah, this is, okay. I ain't got no sage for all that. You know what I'm saying? I ain't got no sage for all that. Hold on, slow down. You know, because at the end of it, you find yourself with a headache. You find yourself tense. You find yourself confused. You want to go to sleep a lot because you really, our version of sleep is kind of like we hiding. Like, I want to hide from you. This is too much. I want to go to sleep. I want to be in an astral plane. You know what I'm saying? So, y'all want to touch in on that?
When I first came into, I guess, my spiritual awakening, you feel like this high, that you want to help everybody, mm-hmm. do for everybody.
Mm-hmm.
But, like, you'll wear yourself thin, and then you want to do for yourself.
Yes.
And so, I like the fact that we emphasize self-help. Self-help, like you have a whole self-help, self-care day that everybody should have. If it's Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, whatever day works for you,
right.
Take care of yourself.
Yeah. Right.
Ashay, what I want to say is knowing who you are, and we're talking about the energy and the vibrations, we're talking about the circuitry, You know what I'm saying? How is these electrical frequencies and information is being moved throughout your body, and what is the operations happening? If the operations is happening interior on the inside, then you know that these operations is happening exteriorly. And so the crystals, you know, your mental fortitude, you know, we started talking about your aura. You know, this is your barrier to be able to keep yourself on guard. This is your vibration. Your vibration get low because your aura is out of whack.
Right.
You know, things have infiltrated your aura. And so this is the understanding of who you are, so that you're doing the necessary work. You know, watching your thoughts, watching the incoming thoughts, okay? You know, because what's coming in is going to be what's going out.
Right.
Period.
But so bad. Oh, no. I'm sorry. I cut you off.
You keep.
I thought you was done. You paused and went, keep on.
But yes. Man, you know, this is the importance that I can just keep saying, man. We have to know who you are all the way through to the root and to the tutor. Not just you, your skin, because you also that spirit, that fire, that light at the center.
Right.
And all that stuff, that all the process that happens after the spark. Okay.
My bro say, from the skin within. I'll tap in on what each of them said. My brother Tahuti was expressing a self-care day. So the beginning of this year has been awesome. Monday is Elegua's day. So being that I embody Elegua and also Sobek, those are two entities that operate in the dark. Behind the scenes. So when you operate behind the scenes, you do a lot more than people realize, which can be extremely draining. Most spiritual workers operate behind the scenes. Even when we sleep, a lot may not want to realize it, but we go into another plane and still do work on the spiritual realm. Mm-hmm. So that's another reason why some of us are even tired when we awaken, because many of our families were just vehicles that brought us to this plane. They always say blood is thicker than water. Mm-hmm. That is true from the point of viscosity and things of that nature. But in truth, sometimes in your walk, you will find people that you realize, okay, we family from somewhere else that I don't seem to mentally or physically comprehend. That's your spiritual family that on another realm, y'all decided, hey, we're going to go here. We're going to make things shake. We're going to take care of ourselves first, get to know ourselves first, and then come together. So tying back with Tahuti said, like, Monday is Elegua's day. So the 5th was my solar return. The 6th is Elegua's or Eshu's feast day. So, yo, this week, spirit and universe been telling me, chill out.
Yes, sir.
Relax. The instance we was discussing when we first came on about the music being played. Yesterday, I prepared everything for my offering for Eshu. One of my bros, I know he a good dude. He blows the leaves around the apartment. Never has he come upstairs and blew the leaves. Never. But as soon as I put my offering outside, for some reason, he comes upstairs. I'm like, wow, I see this. So I said an incantation that I got from Galacticus for banishing demons and djinns. And he went right back downstairs. It was awesome. And my brother Ra was saying that you have to know yourself from the skin within. When you do your shadow work and you understand who you really are, you understand what you will accept in life.
There you go.
What you will appreciate, what you will deal with, what you really want. Because some of us lie to ourselves about what we really want in life, and then we wonder why we don't get what we want. Because the universe is only going to give you a mirror of what you say you want. So if you sit in confusion, it's exactly what you're going to get back.
Right.
And look at America. America has forever been sending out confusion. Mm-hmm. Now everything is coming full circle. And those that it don't pertain to, the only way you're going to get involved in that confusion is if you put yourself in it. Mm-hmm. If it ain't got nothing to do with you, as my sister Jen used to say, mind your own spiritual business.
I say. Well, see, let me go and get my woke statement in for the night. My metaphysical statement, because we don't do woke, we metaphysical.
Yes.
So,
yes, sir.
You mentioned blood. See, I look at blood differently. Like, I call y'all blood. All right, blood is that fluid that goes to your body to promote life, right? Filled with nutrients. So if you give me life, part of my life force is blood.
Yes, sir.
Right? Mm-hmm. I call my chakra phantom family my tribe family. That's my bloodline. That's my family. That's my family family. I don't say you my play brothers. I say you my brothers. Yes. It sounds kind of whack too. Yes. But yeah. No, these are my brothers right here. And I defend them, look out for them like we brothers. For real. You touch my brother, scorched earth. You can touch my sisters in the tribe, scorched earth. You know, because that's my family. Touch my little niece, my nephews or nieces, scorched earth. You know, because at the end of it, blood or family to me are those people that are willing to enrich every part of you. You know, you have relatives, sure. And they but I always say every relative ain't family, just like I say every old person ain't elder. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So when I look at brothers and sisters that can share that wisdom, or they call me like Afar does, Zahuti does, and Sonny, or Ra does every once in a while, you know. Hey, brother, how you doing? You doing all right? And I'm having a bad day. But it picks me up like, man, you know, I could be a little better, you know. And it helps me to have a positive outlook no matter what. If it's bad, I usually be like, man, I had a day today. You know, it's not, oh, I had the worst day ever. No, you know, just had a day, I'll be all right. That's my favorite answer. But and that's most men's answer. Yes. We'll be all right. Now, speaking of that, the importance of men healing.
Yes. Yes.
Who want to go first?
I think you should, brother.
When you get on my
Well, how did your journey go through that book?
Woo! Man Heal Thyself by Queen of Ool. I thank these brothers right here because them plus a few other brothers, Oscar, homage to him, Afari, homage to him. The other brothers, we sat up in the group and we said we needed to learn on healing. They know I had went through a kind of experience where a relationship ended and I was hurt. And they know I needed to go through healing, so we all went through it together. And it also showed the significance of male bonding. Yeah. Male bonding, for sisters to say, why you gotta go hang with his homeboy? Let me tell you something. If you have friends, if you first of all, you know what kind of man by the circle he's around. That's one. But two, every once in a while, men need the opinion of men. Not by boys, men. So there'll be a time that they'll tell, hey man, you wrong. Or hey man, you alright. And they can see you hurt. But it taught me that the ability to be transparent enough that if I had to shed a tear in front of my brothers, which is hard for men to do, people. It's hard for men to do. Men crying in front of another man, forget about it. I'm straight. I'm good. He'll cry in the car. He'll be in a fetal position, rolling around. And Tahuti be like, come on, you good? Yes. But won't get out that car. But now it's like, they helped me to look into myself. That book and my brother's support helped me actually look and say, no, okay. What's wrong with man? This. And we don't look at each other no less. No. You still a man. You more man because you said you hurt. So we sat down as a collective. So what did I do for healing? One, I faced myself. And I'm still facing myself to this day. That's the importance of my self-care days. My self-care days are designed to face me. Not to kick it by myself. Not to go run down the street, run the streets, do whatever. It's to work out, which is a meditation. Walk in the woods, which is a meditation. Clean the house, clean in the temple, which is a meditation. Make sure Ogun has what he needs. Make sure the ancestors have what they need. Go sit outside. Let the wind hit you. Sit in the sunlight. Reflect on yourself while I'm sitting there. A lot of the times I'm focused on what I did that week, how I handled the situation. Was I correct? Was I incorrect? What could be changed? Am I patient? Kind of. But there are certain things I'm not patient on. Still working. But it also helps you to embrace your fallibility. I'm fallible. I'm not gonna do everything perfect. As much as the 42 laws of Ma'ata said, that's why they have positive and negative confessions. Right? Because when Ma'ata made it, she was like, they probably gonna screw this up. You know, so I sit there and go, yeah, I could have did this better. I could have did that better. So I take that time to walk and get to know me. Or I might literally go get a massage, my hair done, get a pedicure, manicure, just something for me. That's my selfish day, because you have to pray to yourself. So I tell people, yes. Did you pray today?
Yes.
And they say, what you mean? Did you pray today? Did you pray to God today? Did you pray to Goddess today? Yeah, I got down on my knees. Did you look in the mirror and pray to God and Goddess today? Because you keep forgetting to talk to yourself.
Yes.
That sounds crazy to some people. Like, go talk. No, I do. I have straight up conversations. Like, yo, man, I can do that better. I'm tripping. Nah, I shouldn't did that. You know? And then I sit down, but it's a reflection moment.
Yes, sir.
Then I say, like, for instance, I had a coworker, another brother that I had an issue with. And me and him was going back and forth, and I just didn't talk to him for a couple of weeks. Then I sat there and I said, how long are you going to be mad about that, dog? Was it even worth you being mad in the first place? So I'm literally walking and working. Nah, I probably shouldn't have did that. Grinding metal. You know, he said that to tick me off, but I did say that, and I could see how that could set him off. Lunchtime came, I tapped him on the shoulder, man, you got a minute? He came outside aggressive, you know how we do. Mm-hmm. Well, it's going to go down, it's going to go down. So I'm like, calm down. Slow down, hit the brakes. You know, so I said, nah, I want to apologize to you. I want to apologize for what I said. I didn't like how I came at you. You can, you know, you can choose to accept the apology. I'm not asking you for forgiveness. I'm doing this for me. We forget to do that. Right. Like, you don't do that for you. You know, it's very important that you, if I apologize to somebody, I'm apologizing, one, for acknowledgement. Two, to tell me that I screwed up. Three, to indicate what I need to work on. It is not to stroke your ego. It is not to make you feel good, because you could have did something that warranted me saying, hey, idiot, check yourself. But because I said, hey, idiot, check yourself, I might go, nah, I could have said that better.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Right. And sometimes other people would make you see yourself when you don't want to, because I'm stubborn sometimes. Sometimes it's a good stubborn, sometimes it ain't. You know? But the beauty of self-care, and I'm glad you made me go first, because you're going second. made me say that I needed to heal. That was the first part. You can't heal yourself without first acknowledging that you need to heal. And when you do that, that's the first part of the work, because you have literally have admitted to yourself that you need to heal from whatever it is. I got a trauma. What's the trauma? Because this is the questions you ask me in the mirror, because your real reflection talks back to you. Mm-hmm. You look in the mirror, and you look up, and that was the first time in about 3 years that I actually stared in the mirror at myself. I usually do this. You see what I'm saying? No, I have to look at those demons. Literally, and go, man, I need to heal. And the reflection's like, is that right? What do you need to heal from, sir? Mm-hmm. But, you know, I'm feeling like this. Why are you feeling that way? Well, because of this, and this didn't work out. Okay, so all right. So what happened? Well, she did this. All right, pause. Yeah. What did you do?
Yes,
what could you have done better? Yes. Well, I could do this better. You know, I could have done that better. Well, you know, next time going forward, next person, do better. But the thing is, when we really acknowledge that, a lot of us, I realized today, there was a sister that texted me, like, wanted me to be Dr. Phil. I'm not a therapist. I'm the one person. Don't ask me no questions, because I ain't going to sugarcoat the answer. But she asked me, she's like, I don't know. I'm just so depressed because I'm going through so much in my life and this and this and this. I don't know what to do. I said, face yourself. And she said, what you mean face yourself? I said, well, you're not perfect. You do stuff. I listen to you tell me about all five of your husbands that you're getting, the fifth husband that you're getting a divorce from. You said what they did. But I've been knowing you for over 22 years. So my question to you as a friend is, what did you do? And I said, before you answer that question to me, look in the mirror and say, that's what everybody needs to do. Look in the mirror and say what you did. Nobody's perfect, man. And I ain't just talking about in relationships. I'm just talking about as an individual. If we're going to reach our son and bone, because we're quick to say, noop, poo-noop, right? I am that I am. And everybody does this. I am noop, poo-noop.
Right.
And steps out like that. They said the most comedic thing ever. What it is noop-poo-noop is not an excuse for you to be an a-hole. Noop-poo-noop is the first stage to you going to your son bonum or your greatest you. So with that being said, Brother Sobek, yes. Let's talk about your healing journey, my brother, my Asiatic brother.
All right. I would have liked to say it in the past that I didn't have a whole lot to heal from, that I had dealt with it all. For many that know me, I did 5 years and am still on parole for a date I'm not going to continue to speak because I'm not going to put that energy out to hold me to that time frame.
I see.
But I did 5 years in which I had a lot of time to look at myself. And I thought I was healed until I was put into a lot of the same situations when I came home. And I still reacted like a little boy. Mm. I still operated with the excuse that, well, if you're not going to show me loyalty, I don't owe you loyalty. If you're not going to be truthful with me, I don't owe you truth. If you're not going to be, if you're going to be distrustworthy, I don't owe you trust. Mm. Which wasn't me standing on my square, which wasn't me standing at the pinnacle of my own personal pyramid to say that I am healed. So this past year, man, I was doing videos like every day. And I would always say that I was speaking to myself. But it wasn't until after I had done my shadow work that I went back and started listening to some of the videos and was like, bro, your higher self was talking to you the whole time. And you wasn't paying no attention. Mm-hmm. You giving all the good advice and not following it. Even with all the meditation I was doing. Even with all the sage burning I was doing. Even with all the pyramids I was doing and crystal work I was doing. I still was hiding behind my own shadow. There were things that I wasn't acknowledging that I want in life or how I want to operate in life that, in truth, based on African culture, is acceptable. It's wonderful. It's understandable. Even if you look up certain teachings by Madame Blavatsky or Aleister Crowley, and the law is to do as you please as long as you don't hurt anybody else. A lot of us don't realize we operate from that stance, but we still allow ourselves to fall into the hypnosis of expectation. That's what I like to call it, yeah. Where you're dealing and maneuvering a certain way not to piss anybody else off, and you still not happy. And I myself still wasn't happy. Yeah, there were certain aspects that I was being completely honest with myself, but then there were other aspects that I wasn't. I was allowing myself to operate in a different manner physically than I was wanting spiritually. And again, you can't expect something if you're not giving off exactly what you want. You have to operate in the frequency of what you want. That is the truest aspect of manifestation. So me, myself, I was dealing with a lot of trauma from childhood, relationships, and so on and so on, and I'm not going to give a whole lot of energy to, because like my brother Moon said, healing is an everyday process.
Yes.
Some days you have to wake up and acknowledge, hey, I still need healing in this area. Or hey, issue might have happened the day prior that you go back and, as my brother Afari taught me, it's called recapitulating. You go back and you play out a situation in your mind, almost in meditation. And at the point that you're feeling those intense emotions, you change it into how it should have played out. Mm-hmm. It's funny because shortly after that, I watched a movie not too long ago where that's exactly what a female did at the end. She had did a whole bunch of crazy stuff. And at the end of the movie, even though things didn't go the way they should have, she played it out the way she wanted it to be. And that's really like quantum leaping. That's like jumping to a different timeline and then going from the flow of that moment in that point. You're not changing the past, but you're changing how you react to the past as far as how you respond to the future. So my biggest part of shadow work was doing exactly like my brother said it, like my mama tells me. Sometimes the only way to keep sane is to talk to yourself.
Mm-hmm.
So I did a lot of staring in the mirror, a lot of staring in candles, a lot of meditation in my mind of calming down the monkey mind and talking to myself.
Now, what is the monkey mind?
The monkey mind is the principle that whenever you sit to try to steal your mind and you try to focus on certain things, because of the confusion that my brother, how did you say it exactly? The you were talking about the confusion.
Cross-transmittal confusion.
Cross-transmittal confusion. Mm-hmm. Look at it like this. We're all antennas. So if you're not grounded properly, you're going to pick up any station that's around you. Many of us are more empathic than we believe. So the monkey mind aspect is, you ever wake up and you think about a person that you really didn't want to think about? That wasn't your thoughts. That was that individual thoughts. But y'all are still connected because there's soul ties, karmic ties, sexual ties that many of us haven't dealt with. So the monkey mind aspect is your connection to all of the things that you have to learn to cut off to tap inside your highest self, which is peace, stillness. You ever heard people say the stillness, or how do they say it? God speaks in a small, still voice.
Mm-hmm.
That's because that's your higher self trying to get to you
over all of the noise that you hear all the time. And the only way to be able to hear that is to be in silence. Many people don't get their prayers answered because they don't shut up long enough to hear the answer.
Shut up means cut off your lights. I tell people, if you want to meditate right, this is how I would meditate. This is how I normally meditate. I turn off lights, no music, just me and the universe. And they go, why no lights? There's this thing called white noise. You can't hear a light bulb go off, but if you get close enough, you hit noise.
Yes. Noise.
The ancestors will not talk to you around noise. So if somebody comes in and you meditate and they go, hey man, how you doing? And that's why I get irate. Hey man, shut up. Because I was probably talking to a goon sitting right there, right at that moment. Or sitting right there talking to my Bible, may he rest in power, at that exact moment. Or basically, or better yet, talking to my higher self at that very moment. I had just reached that plane, just saw myself walking up. Hey, what's up, God? And then I got to go. Noise. Now I'm mad because I can't get the answer. So a lot of us don't get the answers we're supposed to get because we're too busy making noise. I tell people, when you pray, make it short. If you look at the cartoon Thundercats, all right? Lionel pulled out the sword of Thunder, and he said a real small prayer. Ah, Thunder, give me sight beyond sight. Close his eyes. Boom. That was meditation. Because as soon as he put it up to his forehead, that eye opened. His third eye.
Yes, yes.
Boom. Went out there, and he had to get the foresight. Right? But interesting enough, he couldn't do it if he didn't have the sword. That teaches something else. If you're not spiritually grounded and protected, you don't have your protection with you. You might not be able to reach where you got to go. But if you have a little extra, you got a little bit. I mean, as a matter of fact, if you look at Mum-Ra, how he had the Kundalini symbols and everything like that. There's cartoons that teach you a lot. Cartoons told me about Al-Qaeda. G.I. Joe taught me about Al-Qaeda because I was Cobra.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
That's the game.
Yeah, taught me all about everything that's happening. If you just really pay attention.
Yeah. I got one for you, Flintstones.
Talk about that one.
Speak on
it. All right.
Yeah.
See, he finna get this. He started it. Hey, man, let me think about
we missed it, right? We missed it. You have, why did my brain leave? Okay, how many melanated characters do you remember on Flintstones?
Maybe one.
Right.
Does the alien count?
The alien could count, but there was a little boy. And the only time you would see him is he would come in and bring inventions and then burn off.
Right.
Dang, I hate my brain does this. Somebody Google it for me. Somebody Google I know everybody's
camera. I don't watch the Flintstone.
I know somebody on here. Come, somebody on here Google Black Flintstone characters.
Black Flintstone characters. I'll be back, y'all.
Because his name is...
It's significant.
It's significant to crystals.
Okay, keep talking.
So whenever you would see him come around. Matter of fact, in the newer cartoons, they actually have three. His father was a police officer. The other black character, or melanated individual, is the mayor.
Okay.
And it's a goddess. So you have three characters. You have a female mayor, a police officer, and a young child.
Okay.
That his sole purpose is only to come in and give technology.
Oh, snap. Okay.
What's his name?
Let me find it real quick.
Philo Quartz. Okay, my boy right there.
Philo Quartz. Oh, wow.
And quartz is what? Quartz is one of the most powerful stones.
Yes, sir.
Computers use quartz.
Yes,
I'm sure.
Our body is made of what? They'll say we carbon-based beings.
Quartz-based.
Right, because the opposite of carbon is silica. Silica is quartz. The pyramids were nothing more than energy chambers. If you take an aerial view of many of the plains, whether it be in Egypt, whether it be in Mayan cultures, even in some Hindu cultures, when you look down from the sky, it looks like a computer motherboard.
Yeah.
When you look at the micro and the macrocosm,
yes, sir.
What? So above, so below.
Right.
When you look into the universe, you see the stars aligned in the same way. So on the planetary level, we are the same way. We actually are individuals that should be embodying more pure metals. Gold, silver, copper, and in its monoatomic form. He finna got found here.
I know y'all know these dudes don't look like they went to nobody's school, but they just said 8, 9, 10 Harvard-related words. That's a MIT word. What kind of people do I hang with? But anyway, please continue.
You want to tap in?
You got it, bro. Look, you can finish what you're saying, man.
All right, like gold. There was a book called Secrets of the Holy Grail Kings, and it talks about monoatomic gold in its pure form. When you hear on scripture about manna, manna wasn't a bread. There was an individual who got some land. He didn't know how to bring it back, so he injected nitrogen into the ground. And what he saw the next day was what looked like little clouds, and he was able to pick it up. When you look at the metal netter and you see the release of the deities holding containers that look like powders in it, that's monoatomic gold.
Okay.
Gold is a conductor.
Right.
Even when if you've heard about the Nephilim, a lot of these gold veins that they're finding is believed to be the heels of the giants, because all of the blood and the gold that was in the blood as they died went to the heels of the feet. So these deposits are actually their blood that you're finding all of this gold in, which we should be intaking more monoatomic gold. The Bro 19 Key sells it. And it changes up the way you think, because your body now has more conductivity, which also affects your brain, which also creates new neurons and allows for faster firing.
Okay, now where do you find that again?
19 Keys has it. It had to be on his site.
Monoatomic
gold.
Ormus. You know what I'm saying?
It's a milky white substance.
Hey, get your DNA repaired, man.
I'm going to get some.
We're talking vibrations.
I already lift over 400 pounds. I'll take some monoatomic gold, player. I might be bench pressing 1,000 pounds for 1,000
And I'd like to tell people, like, into when it's taking the monoatomic, that it's really like a long shower. You have, this is something that you want to start making such a regular routine, and you'll take it for a while, and then you'll go off of it for a little bit, and then you'll pick back up. But it's just like the healing path that you're on, because this is our repairing time. It's time to repair, because now we got unlimited access to the energies and the tools necessary to repair our DNA and get back to everything all you dreaming of. It might take you 5 years, 10 years.
It's worth it.
But it's all about the consistency of the work, and those who have walked this path understand that microcosm, you know what I'm saying? This process that's embedded in everything.
Right.
It's gonna start 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You gotta follow the steps.
Okay.
That's right.
So with that, we're going to go into another song right quick, get y'all set up, and we're going to build a little more. And whenever y'all ready to play, we're ready to let you play.
We can play right now.
Can play as the music goes, baby. After that, I like this build that we got going on right now. I want y'all to get everything out. So when we come back off of our break, I'm going to come back and ask you some questions about how you got your name and where we're going from here.
Ashe.
All right. Ashe. Let's keep it going, baby.
But in my mind, my two minutes with the dream.
talking about, why she hit me? I'm like, okay, she tried to do it. I don't know what's going on.
I'm making a piece of jewelry. I just want to know what color.
Ah. Whatever the universe tells you.
All right. So it will be.
We got to get in their business, y'all.
Let's get in the business.
So, what's Chakra Phantom all about? First of all, I'm going to say it like this. That was the dopest name for a T. I heard it. Like Chakra Phantom. I was like, man, I wish I could be a Chakra Phantom.
You are.
So, who came up with the concept of Chakra Phantom? And what's that all about?
Many moons ago, we discovered crystals.
Yes.
And we were basically healing people because we were infatuated. I was infatuated with the colors. Mm-hmm. Really didn't know what crystals can do, but then I would make jewelry for people, and they'd say this would happen. I was like, well, you were just supposed to be cute. That's not supposed to happen.
Mm-hmm.
And then I started to research what these crystals do and the effects they have on people.
Mm-hmm.
And so my brother Ra and the mother of my child, they tell me in the same week, you know what, we should sell our jewelry. I was like, okay, we should sell our jewelry. What is a wonderful name for a brand or whatever?
Mm-hmm.
And I'm actually listening to Jay Electronica, and on Shiny Suit Theory, he says something about melanated phantom of the chakra. I was like, that's it. I hope he doesn't sue me. And so, and so that's what we rocked with.
Okay. So when did you all get established?
We've been established, I guess, officially through the 2018.
2018 really was the rocket ship. Right. We didn't know we was on, you know, really.
Was it right before Harvey?
I guess really, because it started that summer.
Right.
It started that summer.
Like Harvey pushed us into it. It was like, this is what y'all need.
We ain't going back to work no more.
Right. Not going to work no more. So
yeah, we're about to have to, you know, we're going for ourselves now.
And look at you all now. This brother right here in the back. So back.
Yes.
You can see brother So back. What I love about So back is you can literally look at his Instagram page if you want to have a great day.
That's right.
And this man will be doing all kind of dog on acrobatics. And sometimes I'll be worried about him because he's like a brother to me. So I'd be like, don't do that. You're going to hurt yourself. And then as soon as he turns and flips, he'll be like, boom. I'm like, see, told you. And he goes, peace, love, and bless the family. I'm like, you know that hurt. You know that hurt. So tell everybody about yourself, man.
Well, I'm a life coach. I'm a veteran. First and foremost, I'm a father. Army.
Well, everybody ain't perfect.
But y'all are redheaded stepchildren of the Navy.
We gonna delete that. This is my show. You ain't talking to me like that. What's wrong with you? This show is over. We gonna bring this home. Put him on coming up next.
Look, I had to pause all the way to see if someone's gonna go flying at me. I have accepted the fact that I'm also a shaman and a master builder.
Okay.
Many of us, as far as my tribal brothers, we end up fulfilling spaces that need to be filled.
Gotcha.
So I started learning to work with crystals as well. I think some of the first ones I saw, I met my brother Afari at a black market. And there was this awesome piece. It was like a Wakanda protection piece with a hamsa on it that's like this big. Mm. And before that, I had just started my shaman journey. Mm. While I was there, I kept wondering about pyramids because I would see nobody making them. Mm. So I myself, the ancestors told me, start doing it yourself. I'm like, how the hell am I supposed to do that? And it was just like these, but I would make pieces and then other people would come tell me, oh, I could feel the energy off of that. Mm. I didn't realize that it was me putting my energy into it. Mm. It's like the brother said with my page, I try to put my energy into everything, even to where last year at the end of the year, I got a reading that told me I needed to calm down before I hurt myself. Mm. So I stopped doing a lot of videos. Just Monday, I tried to do one. I tried to run from behind a tree, and luckily I got cat-like reflexes. I flipped and got back up and then tried again and almost fell again. And the universe was telling me, sit your behind down. Calm down, relax. Now is the time of healing.
Man. We ain't 15 and 20 no more.
And like Ross said, now is the time of healing. A lot of people are going to start doing shadow work this year because it was prominent. Especially with a lot of the planets moving out of retrograde that were causing a lot of disruptions. Those planets aren't going to be in those areas anymore. So now people can readily deal with certain things that they might not have wanted to.
All right. Okay. We're talking planets.
Yes.
Planets.
Okay. So with that, I think because everybody chimed in and it was like, well, what about the sound bad? I know everybody's like, you see all these nice bulbs. So we're gonna play around a little bit. We're going to let the Chakra Phantoms do their thing. What is that drum in the back, brother? See, he got all the good stuff. See, this one. See, look, man. Hold on. I got to turn this back on me. Look, I love my brothers. But they've been having toys. And it's like, what is that in the back? You ain't telling me nothing about. What is that?
This is a tank drum.
A tank drum.
Yes.
Okay.
And one side is A minor and the other side is F major. And my brother Rod just informed me, because you learn as you go a lot of times, that one side is for the third eye chakra and the other side is for the heart chakra.
Ooh, didn't know that.
They got their own verbal vibrational rape. All right.
They don't want it. So,
they got to drop their eye drops, baby. All right, so what we're going to do right now, families, we're going to go ahead and we're going to go into a nice initial session. This ain't deep session. That's coming. But right now, we played enough music and my brother's are ready to go. They got their Wakanda shuffle going, see? They got the Wakanda shuffle. And now we're going to go into a nice session. So with that being said, again, you're listening to Vibration Station Radio by way of the great, legendary Chakra Phantom. Synonymous with a name called Baba Legba, which is synonymous with the name Anpu, which is synonymous with the name Anubis. So we can say at this present point in time, the way has been opened. We're gonna give y'all a minute to get everything together because this next one, we're gonna close out with a brief meditation. But I want to talk about the significance of meditation. Now we touched on it a little bit. But before we get to this phase where everybody's prepping, can you tell them, give them a little more in-depth?
Meditation is the tool of your subconscious and unconscious mind recalibration. Your breathing is what allows you to subdue your nervous system. Directly connected to your breathing. So we have a lot of sporadic breathing throughout the day. When are you focusing on your rate, your breath ratios? You understand? Because this goes directly with your brain waves. We got the alpha, beta, theta, and delta. And so going into meditation allows you to drop your brainwave frequencies so that you can get into the mind states in which you need to do the work in, which is your subconscious and your unconscious minds, which are the liaisons to what you do consciously, your reactionary programming.
But to kind of piggyback off what he said, a lot of us A lot of us don't know how to breathe. We're taking these short, shallow breaths every day, and that's just not helping us. So during this meditation, when you are breathing, make sure you are filling your diaphragm, using your diaphragm to fill your lungs with air. So when you inhale, your belly should go out, not in. And when you exhale, you should contract your diaphragm to breathe all the air out.
Yes,
so just make sure you're breathing correctly.
Yes, sir.
That's so bad.
Also, like my brother was saying, when you begin to learn to control your breathing, especially how he explained about your stomach, when you inhale, your stomach should feel, and when you exhale, you should contract it. Once you start to learn about your chakras and you learn to tap into your root chakra while doing that form of breathing, it begins to open the gateway for your kundalini energy to begin raising. When we hear things about the serpent is your actual sacral energy, or what they call your sexual energy. Mm-hmm. Sexual energy is creative, first and foremost. Mm-hmm. Why? Because when you come together with a partner, you create beings. Well, if you learn to hold and channel that energy within yourself, not only do you become healthier, more creative, you become stronger, you become more able to manifest, because meditation is key to manifesting. Look at it as if you are purposely putting yourself into a dream state to turn your physical world into the reality you want.
I see. It's kind of like, y'all don't be mad at me about this, but Sister Dini. Okay, she's just all right, so if I were to give this to people that didn't quite understand our walk, let's say somebody that was in the church. Y'all don't be mad at me, Christians, but I gotta tell the truth.
Tell it.
The story of Yaqub, someone called Jacob. They said Jacob climbed up Mount Peniel and he wrestled with an angel, and when he came down, his name was Israel. A couple of things. Number one, people didn't know that Israel is literally pronounced like that for a reason. It's an incantation of three deities. That's one. Number two, there's no Mount Peniel except here. There's no Mount Peniel anywhere on the face of the planet. That's Mount Peniel. So when Jacob climbed up the ladder, which is the double helix of the DNA, he wrestled with his higher self. And when he reached his higher self, he came down in the manifestation of Isis, or Aset, Ra, and Elohim. He reached his higher self times three. Interesting concept with that three, because that means his third eye was open. Now, with that being said, that was your woke message for the moment. And for some reason, I got an R right here flashing. Y'all see all this right here? It's an R all around me.
We just play holes.
So that was the true story of Yaqub. You know, we can go into other stuff like genetic splicing and stuff, which I won't touch. We're gonna do that another session. It's another session because he is a father of genetic splicing. Where he talked about he removed the speckled sheep from the white sheep. We're gonna go into our meditation. Before we do, I need everybody to know a couple of things. One, sister said there's a blue, turquoise, and green aura around me while we're talking.
Ashe.
That's what I said, Ashe.
Speak that truth.
Yeah. So,
the truth is.
With that being said, they need to know a couple of things. One, where they can buy your products. Because, hold on, these brothers are swim coaches too. All right. And what is one common tale about black people?
We can't swim. Black people can't swim.
Black people can't swim.
We the ones that can't
swim. I'm scuba quad. I know I can swim. But those two brothers right there are literal swim instructors. Brother Rob, Brother Tehuti. Yes, yes. So, if they want swim instructions, who do they talk to?
If they want swim instructions, go to Big Splash Swim School. We have a page there. If for some reason you can't get there, you want to go to Chocolate Aquaman on Instagram.
What?
If you can't find them there, you want to go to B. Craig forever. If you can't find anybody there, go to Chakra Phantoms. Between those four pages, somebody will show you how to swim.
Ashe. Okay, so jury. Let's talk about it. Because I see between the action figures and the jury itself, because my brothers are decked out, and this ain't nothing they buy. This is stuff that they make.
Yes, all right.
Because I get mad at their bills sometimes. And I'll be like, y'all had a whole bill at the house and they invite me? And then they'd be like, Amon, would you like to come by? See, I'm under a car right now. That's why I'm going to invite you. You're always busy. You going to invite me to the next one.
But I'm coming to your house because you got the lab.
I tell you what.
You got the lab.
You more than welcome to come by, brother. I just got a lot of gun stuff and a lot of tools.
Yes.
So,
yes, we need. We need tools. Cut this.
Well, that's the beautiful thing about family. Y'all are always welcome to my home. Always. Yes, you can always come by. We can hang out. We can build. Bring whatever you want to bring. We can sit down in the living room. We can chop it up like good fellows. And y'all could build, and I can work on metal and get my going on while y'all getting y'all craft on.
Now, he say he don't shape and bend the copper, but he cuts steel and iron. Right.
Alchemy.
He making swords. And...
I am not making swords. I'm making guns, and it's different. Man, you got me telling. Oh, my baby. Anyway. Anyway.
Juice comes out.
About the jury. About the jury.
About the jury, man. Chakra Phantoms. On Instagram is going to be the best way. DM us. Mm-hmm. If you want any custom work, we do all original pieces. So we're not buying anything from China or other people sitting in some sweatshop just making beaded jewelry. Hmm. All our beaded jewelry is made with our hands. So just like Sobek said, the energy go into it. Look, when you get it, when you have the opportunity to take time and understand yourself, you know that every moment you speak, move it, touch, move, that's energy.
Hmm. Please show y'all pieces, man. I mean, come on. Look, listen, y'all. Back in the days, before, you know, I got into this walk, I was in the hip hop gang and everybody had gold. And it was cool. But now I tell everybody that copper's the new gold. Let me show y'all why. Anybody who wants to show their bracelet first?
Go ahead, my friend. We will show you.
Look at this. Look at that.
What is that comprised of?
This is Mukite Jasper, the skeleton head. This Mukite Jasper, ancestral healing. So this is why you got to keep that on you. Because you're always trying to heal your whole lineage from all the trauma that African people have to endure. And this is more healing because this goldstone. And goldstone is just for healing in general, man. Superpower healing stone right here. So,
Power.
Now, my brother, Tehuti.
This is Ukite.
Mm-hmm.
Connects with the heart chakra. Keeps you kind. I have a temper, so it's better for me to stay in a kind spirit. And it really works.
I need one.
Man. It works.
It's such a nice tone.
What about your aunt?
The unk was, my spiritual name is Jehudi, my unk. Mm-hmm. And so instead of getting a big jersey with my name on the back, I got a chain. Last name on it.
So you don't want the No Limit jersey with
this? Nah, I'm not doing No Limit jersey.
All right, brother, so good.
Yes.
You came to Big
Okay, I got a bunch of pieces. I got to put this down now. Because my pieces be comprised of my brother Farid made this one. This is Blue Tiger's Eye and Tektite. Tektite is a meteorite, meaning you will download things from the cosmos. I keep Tiger's Eye on me, which is a grounding stone, which is actually the song of Capricorns. This is Bloodstone, which is another one for ancestral healing, psychic protection. This is Amethyst and Black Obsidian. And also a Tesla plate, which my brother gave me.
Shout out to Farin.
Yes. Amethyst is a good sobriety stone. It helps with communication, helps with dealing with bad habits.
Mm-hmm.
Another piece I started to make myself is called a carcanet. Car in Egyptian and Arabic meant stupid. Ka are stupid or donkey. Ka is our energy, our life force, our chi. Mm-mm. And we know what a net is. So just look at this piece as absorbing and collecting all of the stupid negative energy that you deal with all day and protects you. I also do pyramids, which can embody and have just about anything you want in it. And just like bro was saying, so y'all don't think it's a game. We've been being given game all of our lives in music that we don't understand, especially by individuals that people don't realize are more tapped in than
going to the bank.
They speak.
Going to the bank.
When Pimp C said, I got a pocket full of stones, y'all think it's a game. We keep a pocket full of stones.
Literally.
They got a pocket full of stones.
And these do all kinds of things. I got even more, but that's just to show you. Mm-hmm. And we also make rings for our goddesses.
Got no rings on.
We make these smaller rings for our goddesses. This is an Andera stone, which is good for raising the vibration, helping with raising Kundalini energy.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, hey, either chakra phantoms, Oregon Magnetic Healing, or Barter's World on Instagram.
That's it.
And you can get just about anything you want made.
It's interesting that y'all mentioned Caress. No, you said ka.
Ka.
Now, there's an interesting term that people argue with before we get off into this. What you see right here, I would call, so watch somebody say this is sacrilegious. It's not sacrilegious, it's the truth. What you see here are three Christs.
Yes, sir.
Christ is a mixture of the term ka and caress, which means a higher state of being, elevated self.
Mm-hmm.
So with that being said, you're looking at three Christs right here. Everybody been looking for Christ. You know? I mean, we're walking down the street every day.
Especially from the aspect of legba or a shoe or papa legba.
Mm-hmm.
Because in Catholic beliefs, legba is directly connected to the Christ child of Antioch.
Mm-hmm.
The reason why, when you study the story of Eshu, Eshu was dark matter or time before time. And Eldumare was like, hey, you know what time it is? It's time to create this world. It's time to manifest. And Eshu was like, all right, cool. We can do that. But, you know, I'm going to let you know that I want the biggest piece. I want to be in control. It's like, all right, cool, that's understood. Well, after all of the other Orishas were created, they started picking at Eshu, pretty much saying, hey, you know, you are the most powerful deity, pretty much, but nobody worships you. And they cheated him, teased him like a little kid. So he decided, you know what I'm going to do? It's going to sound very familiar. He decided to incarnate himself into a very wealthy family as a child. Now, we'll tie this to Christianity because folks don't want to realize in those scriptures, when you hear stories about Job and him losing everything, imagine you owning all of Houston and you losing everything and having to start over.
Mm.
These individuals were not poor. When you hear about thousands of sheep and cattle, I don't think poor people had thousands of sheep and cattle. If you have individuals that can travel from city to city and not want for anything because thousands of people are paying their way, that's pretty much saying that these individuals were famous.
Mm-hmm.
Now, mm-hmm. from biblical standards, they try to tell you they were poor because the reality of it is that is our true history. Mm-hmm. Royalty, spiritual, shamans, spirit kings, however you want to put it. So tying it back in, making a long story short, after Eshu rose to being the Orisha that had to be spoken to before you could speak to any others because he healed Obatala when other Orishas couldn't heal him. After he lived his long life and went back to the spirit realm, it was kind of like, hey, what you got to say now? I told you I was the most powerful. So what I had to do is reincarnate myself into humanity, show you I can elevate to the highest point, and then come back. And that's the grand message that we all have been given. When Christians say Christ is in me, I don't think you realize how powerful that statement is.
I am a caress.
Right. You're saying that there is a vibration that is higher than yourself that resides in you. So to also say, I'm going to let Christ take the wheel. If you're not really ready to change your life, then stop playing. Because when higher energies take the wheel, your life will literally turn upside down to get out what needs to be got out to get you in the best place you need to be.
Now, for those who don't understand what this man literally talked about, he talked about the story of Jesus and Job at the same time. All right, so with that being said, I tell people, you know, we know what we say about religion. We know we don't follow religion. We say, I am, you know, I am. You know, I don't need to worry about going to heaven because at the end of the day, I'm already there.
Straight up.
You know what I'm saying? I'm there. And we think it's someone we could touch. You know what I'm saying? It's like heaven's this tangible thing. No, heaven is being at peace within yourself. Yes. I remember a pastor telling me a long time ago when I was in the church, he said, hell is being out of the eyesight of God. Now that I'm walking this walk, I'm like, well, I see myself every day.
Yeah.
But now it translates to hell is when you don't know yourself. Then you're in hell. But when you know yourself, you know what you're capable of, you know what you do. Now you're in heaven. It just depends on what version of heaven you want to be in. You know, it's not, the word is not impossible. The word, they forgot an apostrophe and they needed to separate it. But like I tell you, I don't believe in the word impossible. I am possible. And that's like an Ogun phrase.
It does sound like a shirt.
So it's like, this is impossible. It's impossible to live 400. I'm possible. All because you're telling yourself to do it. You're telling yourself to function. So if we want to, like it says, if you, and I know I keep going back and forth in the Bible, I'm like, what are you talking about? You know, I'm not a Christian, but hey, but I'm just talking real truth because a lot of Christianity came from the mystery system. So with that being said, it says you have the faith the size of a mustard seed, you can move mountains. Well, the thing of the matter is, you can have a little faith. That ain't going to move much. But if I literally stand up and I say, look, I'm going to move this mountain. That's a big statement. You know what I mean? You're looking at this mountain, all right, get out of my way, dude. But, you know, figuratively, they'll say, you can't physically move a mountain. No, but I can climb up and over it. So guess what? Kind of did move it.
Moved it right behind you.
There you go. Everything's not based on literal interpretation. Some things is based on motion. You know, for you to have a blessing in your life, sometimes you have to be able to say, I'm going to manifest this myself. Like I tell people, you keep waiting for something to come out of the sky that's in the form of a human, a God that came down in the form of a human, when you should look in the mirror and realize you're a God, save yourself.
Because
the book Isaiah says, you are the God, children of the Most High. But anyway, I'm going to get on my soapbox. This is the part, Cali Chastity said, okay, I'm going, mind your business. All right, this is the part, everybody. I want you to get to a nice, serene place. My brothers, the Chakra Fellows, my tribal brothers, ancestors in training, smash on sight. We are about to go into a metaphysical portion of this show to where you meditate, you raise your vibrations to a higher level. This is what everybody's been waiting for. You had an intro. Now, with this, I'm going to let them go until they don't want to go no more. I hope y'all enjoyed tonight's show. To my brothers, y'all already know what it is.
Man, much respect.
I love y'all as much as I love y'all as much as I love the universe.
And you know I have to give you something, brother.
They going to give me something.
This is a spirit bag from
thank you,
Chakra Fans.
I ain't sharing my spirit bag. I said that out loud. Hey, so it's mine. All right, but I thank y'all very much. Y'all already know, man. From the crown to the root, I love my brothers very much. So with that being said, the floor is yours. Y'all find a nice, decent place. Close your eyes, meditate, be free of all noise. You listen to the Vibration Station at Temple. Let's do it.
Right now, I want you to find a peaceful place, whether it's sitting down or laying down. whatever is comfortable for you. I want you to close your eyes and allow the melodic tones of these bows to allow you to transcend to a higher plane. I want you to first place your tongue on the roof of your mouth, and on three, expel all the stagnant energy that you are holding. One, two, thank you. outside your body. And then compress down around the outside of your body as a cocoon. A cocoon of healing. A cocoon of love. Now, wherever you're sitting, lying, if you're able to, place your arms around yourself.
I definitely go. I want to give a special thanks again to my brothers, Chakra Phantom. But before we go, let me show you how much I love my brothers, man. Let me show you how much I love my brothers. So bad.
Yes, yes.
Happy Earth Day to you. Happy Earth Day to you. Happy Earth Day. Happy Earth Day. Happy Earth Day to you. It's your birthday. So bad. And then sometimes you got to be able to communicate. And for those that don't know, the reason why these drums are here and the reason why we named this the Vibration Station is because the first known language of the universe is vibration.
Sound.
I think we should let off with a good om session.
Oh, yeah.
I'm gonna let you run that Chaka Fana. I'm gonna get over here, creep over here right quick. But I think everybody watching, we can't let them out with a good on session. And then I got a special treat for them at the end. So please, do your thing.
Y'all ready?
Let's do it.
Yes, yes.
Inhaling deeply through the nose.
Session.
Hotel.
Well, we gotta get this one too.
In the morning light, yeah. Paradox is the cycle through all my fundamentals. Stay journey through all time rolls. Lead you to a realm better known as the crux road. I built the layers from the ground to the roof. Now I planted the seed of evidence to the fruit. Pay 160 degrees based on 13 numbers. Repeat on the frequency of hand when I just spoke. It's time for elevation, called the blueprint is sick. Mathematics, all the secrets universally correct. Align like Orion as I move through the cosmos. Hot as I'm a rider, infiltrators and come close. Speak a middle letter to keep you on the seat. Up your power in every letter to bring you through every sector. And I hit up in my kit for sleepwalkers, I'm a mystery. Hidden and coded without the signs of astrology, basically an anomaly. There's no earthly way to figure me out. You got an sacred geometry. I'm infinite, my energy is old as creation. Heartbeat is vibration, I see a man in your equation. This is just like the golden mission in my vibration. I can't do the extreme. Rather keep it in balance in order to reach for them sights unseen. Any deviation tells of the dream. I speak in universal language, hoping you can feel it. Trying to make it be middle, but speaking metaphysics. Open up the third eye, testify to it. And pass it out to the people, so you can find to it. I speak in universal language, hoping you can feel it. Trying to make it be middle, but speaking metaphysics. Open up the third eye, testify to it. And pass it out to the people. I hold the key like it's you ready for war like Okaru. We'll kick the nation like I'm Shiro. Set the pace like on a moon. African up in my blood from the womb to the tomb. Get the torch lit for all the eagle. Put my black on soul and wall so solid I make cracks in the concrete. It's all about success, but you won't be able to reach me. For it's like a dude when he's battered and sick. I'm a woman for the struggle to the enemy's check. I was born inside a fire with the number of power. My energy contained by iron and all through media showers. I sign a little ticket if you don't see the story. You gotta unplug if you wanna feel it through the static. Man, I travel to town so far, it ain't no sense in going back. My pen is sober. Figure that you kiss my phone and I picture that. Every single lesson you learn, you just witness the ancestors return. I speak in universal language, hoping you can feel it. Trying to make it better, I speak in general. Open up the third eye, catch the fire to it. Universal language, hoping you can feel it. Trying to make it better, I'm speaking better business. Open up the third eye, catch the fire to it. Pass it on to the people, speak your mind to it.
Hold on, baby. Vibration Station. We are out of the building. I hope you enjoyed tonight. I really enjoyed you. I hope you got some out of this. I hope you got some culture. This is all for the people, all day, all the time. Vibration Stations, where we always keep the vibrations high at all times. Except for me.
Yep.
We got to get a picture, man. That was, y'all asked me history. Y'all the first, this is the first time that anybody of y'all caliber has come into a radio station and done an interview of that kind.
Thank you very much, man.
It made history. And I said, we got to do something that made history.
Yes, sir. Yes.
I'm going to invite Chakra Phantom
up. I'm ready.
Yeah, man, I'm just glad y'all up in here. We got to take a picture, dog. That's going to be in our family archives. That's,
yes, sir.
That's when we old men, we got the newest picture, and then we'll be like, boy, remember we did that. And this ain't going to be the last time, man.
My shirt shedded, I literally just got off work and just changed shirts.
Do you drive a silver Charger?
No.
Okay, that wasn't good.
So, thing is, I think our people need this desperately. I mean, y'all do great work at the park too. That's what I mean. But
your meditation session.
So when you do this right here, this whole thing is designed to bring you not only enlightenment. You give them; they got to give you something called support.
Yes, sir.
You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So please, y'all in the Vibration Station group, at least I think you are. If you're not, let me know. Yeah, if you are, put your links up because people was asking about your jury.
Okay. We'll make sure we do that right now.
And see, that's where I'd be stepping on my own toes because I ain't bring that one pyramid.
Yeah, right,
hey, man. So. But you mentioned it.
Yeah.
That's the important part.
Yeah.
So with that being said, I wouldn't have nobody come up in here and I don't put something in his head.
Yeah,
sure. And this is a dope artist. She does paintings.
We the artist crowd over here. We was just talking about art as we were driving here today.
And also, anytime y'all want to come to the house, y'all family, man, if y'all want to use some tools,
come to the house when we sit in the workshop.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm under a challenger right now, so garage like a grenade went off because I've been putting in starters and fixing actuators.
And you know we ain't done a men's circle in a minute either.
Hey, right. All you got to do is set the date, man. You got the place for it. I'd be glad to open my house up for it.
We need to do that.
Yeah.
Struts. That. Struts should be the topic of...
Struts?
Yeah.
We're changing struts?
Changing struts.
Oh, yeah, that's...
I mean, if you want to... I don't know if you want that smoke.
I want that smoke.
Is that that starter?
No, I'm sorry, not struts. Shocks. Shocks on the back.
At least
it ain't an SUV. I'm going to tell you something. I'd rather change a starter in an SUV any day over that doggone Challenger where everything under the hood is like this. So I had to reach like that. I was like an Autobot. I was transforming up in that truck.
I know, right. Stuff to get like, the starter, yeah. The starter is supposed to be just so easy. It's
supposed to be
to
right there.
To.
No, sir.
Right there. Transmission.
That requires a flashlight, prayer, committed prayer. I had to listen to Moonchild's whole album just to calm down. Have you heard Moonchild's album?
We're going to get a picture right quick so I can use that for the cover photo of the video.
I treat everybody that comes in here. like you're 11. I'm not gonna have you just anything, man. I gotta have a nice confidence. But see, y'all, I got a lot of respect for my brother, number one, number two. It's just, to me, y'all are slaves. We only saving the whole race.
Saving the whole race.
You see your plugs?
Yeah, we only saving everybody.
We only saving.
We on the low.
Watch your phone, so mm-hmm.
You get this kind of advice. I'm gonna go home and record something.
Yeah, that's why I want to see an artist should listen to this station and be like, I want to go to the lab.
Yeah.
Because I want Sobat back up in there because he think I forgot that he do rap music.
Right. Yes. This man can spit.
And I heard him. Bars. And I was like, is that J-Dog or is that Sobat?